more footprints.
Congratulations, Inspector. You've discovered more footprints belonging to the deceased. Timeline discrepancy detected nearby. Congratulations, Inspector. You've discovered more footprints belonging to the deceased actress known as Halcyon Helen. Timeline discrepancy detected nearby. Congratulations, Inspector. You've discovered more footprints belonging to the deceased actress known as Halcyon Helen. Timeline discrepancy detected nearby. Congratulations, Inspector. You've discovered more footprints belonging to the deceased actress known as Halcyon Helen.
What? Oh, it's the Exterminator Automech Depot. I thought we were back at the warehouse. What's over there? Wait over here.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Potting shed? Freaking out over here.
Congratulations, Inspector. You've discovered more footprints belonging to the deceased actress known as Halcyon Helen.
More footprints?
Congratulations, Inspector. You've discovered more footprints belonging to the deceased actress known as Halcyon Helen.
Hopefully this adds it to our map or something like that. I've been in here. Show you happiness. I don't think I'm. Yeah, I'm walking into this stuff.
Oh yeah, that's funny.
Real funny. Giving me the chuckles you are. Oh yeah, that's funny.
I just wanted to make you smile.
Everyone all right?
I just wanted to make you smile.
They're not dead yet. I gotta fix this thing. RR&DD
Lab. Helen was at this lab too. We're close to finding something. I can feel it.
Yeah, man. But I wanna run up here and see where those hosts went up to. I guess they are dead. And what are these parasites? Tasty. It's just so darn tasty that it makes you insane.
Happy customers are repeat customers.
Happy customers are repeat customers.
Haven't heard that anywhere before. Ugh.
Okay, keep him quiet.
Trying to get us all in trouble. What do you think you're doing?
I was just leaving.
Do what you want, I guess.
Well, we can pick, but that we can take. So we're free to take this stuff, we just can't pick the lock. I don't know if the reputation decreased because we took that stuff or because of the lock was picked. It said take though. Come on in here. Let's not decrease our reputation anymore. Chapter 1 continued. Ew, I don't remember that. Haha! Are those Halcyon Helen and Typhon Tim I spy crouching in the dark like terrified sprats? Fine job you two did on my shift. Most of my crew was torn to bits by the rampaging beasts. I have found you to pay you back with interest. I say we shall defer that payment, shouted Typhon Tim, and his hand flew to his holstered automag. Ere his fingers even touched the weapon's grip, he was struck 15 times in the face by a hail of bullets from Mercer's weapons, at which point he promptly expired. Helen, cool as usual in the face of death, hefted her bottle of nearly 100% meal grub-free purpleberry liqueur, nearly 100%, and hurled it toward the villain. Her aim was true as ever, and the projectile struck Mercer in the forehead, knocking him out so soundly he could not even utter a curse. Fine aim, ma'am, said a woman close by, once the other patrons' cheers subsided, though I must say I am sorry for your friend. As was I at first, but then I witnessed what lay in the wake of the bullets. Look! And as she gestured at what was left of Typhon Tim's head, something small and black began to wriggle amongst the gore. Oh, wow. Rest in peace, Typhon Tim. I like those boxes. Like breakfast cereal. Oh, that's right. Overweight. All right. This thing is an interesting name, but yeah, I'm gonna get rid of it. Alright, so we got tactical shotgun 2, grenade launcher 3, machine gun 2, the vermin. Light assault rifle mark 3. I'll keep that. Right. Standard troop armor. Alright, get rid of this. Okay. So this, the one I like the most, which I gotta fix, is this. That's a long gun. So let's increase long gun. 100. It can go higher. Alright, 102 for long gun. Percent companion ability damage. And then same here. Alright, to do 30% more damage now. And what about me? Don't I have perks or something? No, zero right now. The R&D labs. I do want to go there. But I want to be thorough here and take care of everything else. Didn't I just ran up here, right? Yeah. Oh, I got stuck between this stuff? Ooh. Around here. Speed grip. Weapon mod. Alright, let's get this thing. There was another one. This way. Over here. Well, we know that it's just footprints.
Timeline discrepancy detected nearby.
Oh, this thing?
Analysis. This discarded canister is typical of the arm-mounted storage tanks on the orchard's agricultural mechanicals. However, it is not currently attached to a mechanical.
I know.
This canister contains a high amount of vinegar in addition to water. Warning. Use of vinegar, a known herbicide, on purpleberry saplings is a violation of Rizzo's agricultural standards.
Where are these canisters usually kept?
These canisters can typically be found in the nursery storage building in the purpleberry orchards, except for this one, which can be found here.
I see that. Initiate a deeper chemical analysis.
Chemical makeup of substance. 50% water, 50% vinegar. Trace amounts of woolly cow feces also detected.
The feces in this canister was likely used as a liquid fertilizer for these saplings. By the readout, it seems the fertilizer has been here approximately as long as the vinegar. Huh. You don't say. This one, there was one more, like, way up this way. See one there. Oh, and up there. Oh, it's Jacob.
Congratulations, Inspector.
Yeah.
You've discovered more footprints belonging to the deceased actress known as Halcyon Helen.
Does she always leave snacks around? I wonder if it shows up on the map. No, not really. I'm just seeing the exhaust over there from that. Inside that hedge is some more. Check this out then. That's not one of those audio things. Unlock with, I'm just going to call it R&D Lab Security Access Card. Something not...
Hello? I can hear you out there. If you still possess the majority of your mental capacities, please locate the test room through the lobby and to the left. You'll see me through the glass.
There'll be danger. Ten 10% more packaging. Oh, goody. Cassatol. That's somebody. So hard to see through that.
I'll keep quiet.
Reception terminal. Research and development. Oh! RR&DD, Rizzo's Research and Development District. Messages. To Department _ Utility, subject cleanup request. From Department Reception. Hello, I'm so sorry I haven't had a chance to get your name yet and update the terminal. When you have a moment, could you bring a mop to the lobby? Dr. Blossom seems to have had a rather rough night and spilled some coffee on the floor. Thank you. From L. Blossom, subject, what in the architect's blue blazes is going on? To department, all RR&DD Labs employees. Blue blazes. What in blessed corporate law is all that commotion down there? I don't believe the rocket fuel combination distillery mixture was scheduled for another week. Could someone please inform me as to what the racket is all about? You better have a damn good reason for interrupting my meeting with the administrator. I expect a full explanation and apology within the next 15 minutes, or people are going to start losing jobs. Alright, let's hack it to view recent appointments. Name, Miss Ruth Bellamy. Stage name, Halcyon Helen. Description, lab tour. Name, Administrator Ludovico. Description, product presentation. You know, say. Oh, somebody over there. That's the one told us to meet.
That's awful. Wonder if this poor fella had a family.
Don't know. Rizzo's first product. Before Rizzo's was the confectionery juggernaut you know and love today, it was above average chemical waste management corporation. On one otherwise unremarkable day, an employee on the slurry-stirring shift leaned a little too far over a chemical vat, dropping a single blueberry that had been hidden in his jacket pocket. Instead of being immediately fired for his hazardous incompetence, the employee was given an ultimatum by his supervisor: retrieve the fallen fruit and stay employed. The employee jumped into the vat, swam for the purple berry, and accidentally swallowed it. The rest is history. After he was pulled from the toxic waters, the stirrer stated that the chemical-coated purple berry hadn't been half bad before falling into a toxic coma, giving his supervisor the idea to sterilize and adjust the chemical mixture for human consumption. Soon, the sour-sweet-coated purple berries were more or less edible, becoming Rizzo's first mass-marketed product, the Purple Berry Bunch. Poor guy. I wonder if he had a family. Hello?
How in the aether did you get in here? You're not a Rizzo's authorized. Oh, void it all. matter now? What do you want? Speak up and quickly if you will.
Well, we haven't introduced ourselves. Who are you?
Pardon the blue blazes out of me, but who in the name of the Eternal are you?
I asked you first.
I'll have you know, I am Dr. Leora Blossom, the head of research and development, and you are standing in my lab, uninvited. Now, perhaps you couldn't tell by the empty lobby and general state of disarray, but this is no time to be playing games.
Something's obviously going on here. You really want to sass me right now?
No, you're right. Listen, I'll be direct with you.
Wow.
You see, I've found myself in a bit of a pickle. Some of my lab techs have turned rather aggressive following a recent experiment gone awry.
No kidding.
That's why I've barricaded myself in the lab.
Huh. What goes on in these labs that would turn your researchers against you?
Oh no. They're quite unaware of their actions, I'm afraid. We're a research and development branch of Rizzo's, focused primarily on the Spectrum Vodka line. But the specific research that goes on in this facility is utterly confidential. You understand?
Your hair looks like, yeah, that looks like paper mache. I'll find out when I hunt through the labs, so you might as well tell me up front.
So you've no qualms about snooping through my precious research files?
None at all.
But will you understand the data once you've acquired it?
Maybe.
Essentially, we research new innovations for an array of Rizzo's products. My present troubles stem from one we've just developed. The product's potential for profit is nearly limitless. But I'm afraid explaining the science behind it would far exceed your capability for understanding.
Wow. Okay, then.
Now, was there anything else?
There isn't anything you can do to help?
Yes. I suppose I should make myself useful. Let me think. Ah, I know. I can remotely unlock the supply closets in the lower levels of the lab. Perhaps you'll find some useful apparatus or two in them?
I can take care of your problem, but I'll need you to answer some questions afterwards.
Excellent. You have my gratitude, and soon you'll have my knowledge of Miss Bellamy's recent visit as well. Now, if you'd rather not kill my lab techs during this cleanup, I believe you can dispense a sedative gas from a terminal in the utility room.
Though it may be the more difficult route, I believe we should make every effort to save the lab techs. They are victims here.
The door to the lower labs is sealed for our safety, so you'll need to take the elevator down. I'll unseal the access hallway for you now. Do take care. Ah, you're still alive. I suppose that is opportune. Have some more overwrought of my researchers been dealt with, then?
No, I didn't move yet.
As if I could go anywhere. What a barrel of laughs you are.
Oh, meaning you can't move yet. Okay. Employee Notifications Terminal. Greetings, employees and lab staff. Find helpful memorandums and news here. Memo. Mind the gas canisters. Hello, everyone. This is your friendly custodial staff offering a preemptive apology if the elevator hall is crowded with gas canisters. There are quite a few of them and only one of me, so I'm moving them in loads down to the utility room. Do be cautious. They're filled with a sedative potent enough to put a hungry mama raptodon out cold. Thank you for your understanding. After work bar meetup. Dear esteemed colleagues, my team and I are heading to the Grand Colonial's bar this evening for some drinking and fellowship. All real scientists are welcome to join us. You know, the ones that produce quantifiable data and theorems and don't spend their time jabbering over how this lighting on that bottle would increase customer sentiment. Cheers from someone who understands that market researchers aren't real scientists. Increased protective measures. Team, As we continue our new round of research and product development, I am increasing the required safety gear for lab workers involved. As some of you know, a few recent accidents involving subjects have left workers maimed, scarred, and one worker had their left hand permanently discolored to a shade of lime green. Rizzo's Research and Development District Labs is expected to continuously produce revolutionary advancements in the food and beverage industry. These measures will help in further pursuit of that mission. Dr. Blossom. Well then. We'll be going down next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.